Hello friends and everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. This video we are going to talk about how to use font awesome in .NET Maui. You know, font awesome contains fonts such as an icon that we can use in application. So before we can have an icons in this application, we have to configure that. So that is what we are going to have a look today. Now this channel facilitates a lot of projects and lessons concerning .NET Maui and also Blazor as WebAssembly. So you can just check the channel playlist. We have a lot of videos that you can take. Let's get going to our today's topic. So first of all, we have to download the font awesome or the font from the fontawesome.com. So let's launch our browser and now let's get going. So we go to fontawesome.com. So let's click on start for free, and maybe we can have this, or we go to the icons. So let's actually go to download, and we have this, so we can download for web or for free for desktop. So let's download it and let's all download this for web. So we can, and the version here, that is a 6.4.2. So that is it. Now, as you can see, it is in a zip file. So we go in there and I try to zip it to have the collection. So let's do that. So now when you come to the folder, you can see we have these two files here. I intentionally downloaded the two because I want to show you something. Now you see, when you go to our projects and when you go to my program.cs file, you can see that the font awesome extension here is what? .ttf. Now, so we have to locate a font awesome in these zip files, which have the extension of what? ttf. Let's extract the first one and see. So we're going to extract this. And when we are done, you're going to extract the second one too. And see, so let's also extract this as well. So this is done. Let's close this one. And let's wait for this to finish. So the first one, that is a desktop, is done. Let's open this and see. Now when you open this folder, let's open it again. Okay, so you see, we have the metadata, we have the OTFS. So when you open all these files, you see all these are font awesome brands. But the extension here, it is a OTFS. And now we need an extension of TTF. So this is the extension that we need, TTF. So let's see. Let's go to the other one. And let's also open it and see. So we can open this. And let's go to the web font. So you can see the web font, this has a font brand, and that is a 400 here. You can see the extension here is what? When you open check the property of this, you can see it is a TTF. Now when you check the property for this too, it is also the TTF. Okay, so this is what you're going to do. Now you have all the web fonts over here. So let's copy this. Or we can open this here. So let's open this maybe in Sublime to see what we have. What we have in. So this is what we have for the font brands over here. So with this, we want to convert this. Okay. So let's convert this to a C# code. Maybe you can see we have solid, we have the FA solid, we have regular, and this is a brand. So all these, you can decide to add all of these to a class. Okay. Now, what can we do? We can just grab this, and that. We can grab any of these, or we can grab all, which have the extension of TTF, and now paste them into a font folder in this. So let's see how we're going to do. Let's first do one because you want to just use this as an example. So let's copy the font brand. So we're going to copy this and I go to our font folder and I let's paste this here. Let's register this. So we're going to open, let's create a copy of this and we paste it. So let's edit, rename this so we can copy the name. Now let's come here and let's paste it. And let's give it a family name. So that is a font. Awesome. Okay. Now, once you're done with this, we have to convert this brand to C# code. So when you go to our web, so in here, we can check convert icons font to C# code. And we can go for this link. So let's wait for this link to open. And we are going to upload. Okay, so that is this one. Now let's go for icon font to code. And now in here, we have to browse for our font awesome code. So let's see. Now let's go for, that is a web font. And now that's the first one. So we have this. And as you can see, we have the code here. So let's grab all this. So the font has been converted to the C# code. Let's copy this. Let's go to our project. Let's create a folder here. And let's name it as maybe models. Let's create a class in it. So add a class. And this class, let's make it as icons. So let's set this to public and static. Now let's paste this here. So we save this. So let's go to our page, that's the main page, and add the model extension here. So XMNS, and now we say models, then CLR-namespace. So demo-models. And now let's create a label. So let's use the fonts here. Let's create label. And now this label, we're going to say font family. So the font family that we're going to use, it is the name that we gave it to, the alias name that the font awesome. So we can grab this and we go to our program or our page here. We paste this. And now let's go for the test. So the test here, we're going to use static files. And here we want to get an icon. So, you know, we have an icon folder here. So before we do that, let's specify our models first. Then we can have our icons dot. So let's go for Facebook. So this is the first icon that we are using. And maybe we can have test color. So let's test color here. Let's set to blue. Maybe we can go for, let's grab this and paste it. So maybe with this, we can cut this and set up a horizontal stack layout and we can paste this here. So let's increase the width request. Maybe you say 100 and let's set the height request also to 100. Now let's do same to this. So let's copy this, let's paste it here. And now let's use same. So with this, you're not going to use Facebook. You want to use YouTube. And you know, let's add this to red. And the last one we can use, maybe TikTok. And that's also to red. Now let's save this. Let's build this application. All right, so you see that our app is now built and we have the icons over here. So that is a way to add font awesome to the Maui project. Now the next thing is, if you want to add, you can see from when we go to our folder, we have this regular and also solid. So all these are also icons. Now you can also grab this and add it to the same class and register it in the Maui program. You can use the same step that we did or we followed to add this icon. You can do the same thing to this. Okay, so that is it for this video. If you like what I'm doing, can give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. As I said earlier on, we have a lot of lessons and projects in the playlist. So check the playlist and you're going to have informative lessons. Thank you and see you in the next video.